This is a jet engine, and this is based on a Brayton cycle. And the air get in suck inside the jet engine. In the front view, we see that there is a number of blades. The rotary blades rotate with a very high velocity, and their volume is get decreases, and the size of a blade is get decreases, and there is a rotor blade which will stop the flowing of air into the outside of that jet engine. So the air get inside it and compressed by the lesser and lesser volume, and the velocity and the temperature and pressure is increases. And right here there is a spark ignition system is placed here, so the high pressure, high temperature air get burn inside the combustion chamber. The fuel get mixed up with the high pressure air, and the temperature of combustion chamber is about 900 degrees centigrade. This is a quite high temperature to burn up fuel, and when the fuel burn up, the pressure is quite high enough to rotate this blade. This is a turbine blade. This blade rotate. This is connected with the same shaft of compressor blade. So the continuous process is going on and on with the help of the combustion, which will increase the pressure of about 9 times the atmospheric pressure. This is quite high enough to run commercial airline flights. So now we are going to talk about the pressure and volume, how the pressure and volume work in the jet engine. So this is from 1 to 2. This is the compression process from 1 to 2. This is 1 and 2. At this point the air get pressurized. Process 1 to 2 is the compression of the sucked air. Their velocity is increases, pressure is increases. So the pressure is get increases from 1 to 2 is the pressure increases. And the 2 to 3, 2 is here is 2 and 3. 2 to 3 is the constant pressure. So the pressure does not change inside the combustion chamber, and we are supplying the heat. So Q heat is supplied. Due to that heat, the fuel is get inside it, and the from 2 to 3 the pressure remains constant, and the 2 to 3 the pressure remains constant, the entire combustion chamber is burn the fuels and the compressed air. And the 3 to 4 is the process where the pressure suddenly decreases and the volume is increases. Volume is increased due to the surface area, and the volume of the chamber is increases in the turbine blade is become broader and broader. This is the convergence blades. 2 to 3 to 4 is the increase in the volume and decrease in the pressure. And this blade is rotated at 4. And at the 4 to 1 is the process where the exhaust come out from the outlet of the jet engine, and the reaction force, and this is the action force and this is the reaction due to which the jet engine will move the aircraft. This is our temperature entropy diagram. And this is from 1 to 2 is the temperature increases. When the air suck inside the jet engine, the temperature of the air get increases. So from 1 to 2, the temperature increases. And the 2 to 3 is the constant pressure. Pressure remains constant. From 2 to 3, pressure remains constant. But we are providing some amount of heat in it. Q in. And the 3 to 4 is that process in which the volume is increases and the entropy is also increases. A less amount of entropy is increases, pressure remains constant in that process. So this one is like that. Now the Q get out, the heat get out from the turbine, and the reactionary force will make the aircraft move in the forward direction.